Before we get into some serious editing, let's talk about the most basic way to edit media to the timeline area. The most obvious approach is to simply select a clip in the event browser and drag it straight to the timeline. Since the select tool is currently active, notice how dragging down another clip automatically snaps to the end of the last clip. That being said, if you are working in list view, you can also drag a clip from the skimming area. In addition, you can also mark predetermined ranges of a clip before dragging it to the timeline. Again, notice how it automatically snaps to the end of my last clip. This is fantastic if you are building a quick montage or simple story. That being said, if you want to place a clip at the exact place you drop it off, change this select tool to the position tool. You'll notice the keyboard shortcut is P to activate the position tool. So now, let's say I pick a range for this clip and drag it to the timeline. When I drop it off, it goes exactly where I place it. You can also select existing clips in the timeline and place them wherever you'd like. If you are a new user from Final Cut Pro 7, think of the position tool as the old default method of what you're used to. Okay, let me reset things here to continue my point. Speaking of which, you can always undo things by pressing Command Z. What's also cool is there's no limit to the number of times you can undo within a project session. Okay, so now I'll go back to the select tool again. Which, by the way, the select tool is the default tool if you're using Final Cut 10 for the first time. So watch, moving a clip while the select tool is active performs a splice. Final Cut Pro will push the other clips to the right to make room for your clip placement. This makes it extremely easy to rearrange your clips within a story. Okay, so now you should know the difference between the position tool and the select tool. It's really important that you've got these two tools down before continuing forward with the training.